Hi, welcome to 1010 News. I'm Dan Daniels alongside John Johnson. Today's story, breaking news, CEO of Tyco, Dennis Kozlowski, arrested.
Kozlowski, alongside with CFO Mark Schwartz, have been accused of inflating the company's income and reportedly have stolen over $150 million.
Here's some live footage of the arrest.
Mr. Kozlowski, Mr. Kozlowski, what do you have to say? Why did you steal all the money? Why did you steal all the money?
On my lawyer.
Tyco, a security systems corporation based out of New Hampshire, America, currently employing 270,000 people, now in hot water after this latest scandal.
Kozlowski has supposedly been involved in numerous transactions in which he has not reported on the company's financial statements.
One of the big four accounting firms, PricewaterhouseCoopers, has failed to properly check the firm's financial statements, and were not able to identify Kozlowski's illegal transactions.
After a further investigation by the SEC, Schwartz and Kozlowski will be held on trial and are facing up to 25 years in prison.
You heard it here first from 1010's Wins. This is Dan Daniels.
And John Johnson.
Signing off.
Mr. Kozlowski, I need to ask you a few questions. If you're honest with me, you may be able to pull a few strings, help you out a bit, but if you're not, there's nothing I can do for you. Why did you evade over $1 million of New York State sales taxes?
I don't know.
Answer the damn question straight, you fool!
I have a spending problem. I saw my opportunity, and I took it. I needed the money to support my lavish lifestyle.
How much did you take?
I took it all and spent it. I bought a $6,000 shower curtain and dropped 2.1 mil on my wifey's 50th birthday.
$6,000 on a shower curtain? Aren't thou insane?
Welcome back to 1010 News here in our new studio. I'm Dan Daniels alongside John Johnson. Here with us is our new sponsor, Snapple Iced Tea.
Feels great to be back, Dan. It's been 3 years now since the Tyco scandal of 2002, and results from the trial are in.
Kozlowski and CFO Mark Schwartz were both found guilty on 22 charges, including grand larceny, falsifying business records, and unjustly going against business law.
Each have been sentenced with 8.5 to 25 years in state correctional facility. Kozlowski has been fined $70 million, and Schwartz $35 million.
In June 2005, Kozlowski was convicted of misappropriating over $400 million of Tyco's corporate funds. Tyco stakeholders affected by this scandal include Kozlowski, Schwartz, Frank Walsh, Mark Belnick, all of Tyco's shareholders, as well as their employees.
Since the scandal, Kozlowski has resigned and has been replaced by CEO Edward Breen. New accounting processes have been implemented and the company has been reorganized.
Since then, the company has recovered quite well and has even won the Center for Corporate Change Award in 2004.
They are currently employing over 70,000 employees, and their stock prices are at $44.19.
Here's Dan Daniels and John Johnson signing off one final time.
Till Stallman's cavalry came. 65. We were hungry, just barely alive. By May the 10th, Richmond had fell. It's a time.